Hello children, welcome again to another class of English language. Today children, we are continuing with the revision chapter and we will be discussing question number 31. In question number 31, we will learn how to join our sentences using the words for, by and without. So now let us start with the first sentence. The bus went by. It did not stop. Now this sentence is to be joined with the word without. Now the first sentence will be written as it is. The second sentence, let us have a look at it. It is in the negative form. It does not have a helping verb. Now what do we do while writing the answer? We add ing to the word stop. Okay, now let us see how we are going to write the answer. We will begin with the first sentence, the bus went by, okay? As the first sentence is, we will write it down, the bus went by. Now, since we have to join both the sentences together, we are going to use the joining word. And what is the joining word? Without. Okay? Now, if we have a look at the second sentence, it is, it did not stop. Now, what did not stop? So, we are talking about the bus. So, it is used instead of the bus. But when we join sentences, we do not need to keep repeating the words that we have already written about or spoken about. So, we will remove the word it. Now, since we have a negative sentence over here, we will remove these words and add ing to the word stop. So what's my answer? The bus went by without stopping. Now let us have a look at the second sentence. Anu was thanked. She was helpful. So if I ask the question as to why she was thanked, I get the answer that she was being helpful. So how do we join the sentence? We join the sentence with the word for. Now let us have a look at this sentence, the second part. It has no main verb, it only has a helping verb. So when we have sentences like that and we need to join them with the word for, what are we going to do? We are going to use the word being, being. Okay, so how are we going to write our answer? Let us start with the first sentence. Anu was thanked. Now, for what was Anu thanked? So, we write the joining word for. Now, we remove the word she since we are already talking about Anu. So, she is removed. The helping verb is removed. Now, what is the word that we need to write? We need to write being. For being helpful. Okay? Now let us have a look at the third sentence. She found the answer. She looked in a book. Now what's the first sentence? She found the answer. Now if you have a look at the second sentence, we have the main verb. And what is the main verb? There is no helping verb. We have the main verb over here. So when we have the main verb, we will change the main verb from the past tense form to the continuous form by adding ing to it. Now, how are we going to write the answer? Let us begin by writing the first part of the answer. She found the answer. Okay? Now, we need to write the joining word. And what is the joining word? By. Okay? By. Now, we need not write the word she since we have already written it over here. So, we need to write the verb. But since our sentence only has the verb, that also in the past tense form, we are going to change the verb to the continuous form by adding ing to it. So, by looking in a book. So, how does she get the answer? She got the answer by looking in a book. So, I hope children, you have understood how we are going to write or join these sentences using for, by and without.